Is it Lassie? Lasse?
Yeah.
Lasse.
Yeah, thank
How
you.
How are you?
From Bedditt.
I'm good, thank you. How are you doing?
Doing great.
That's an interesting name. I just have to ask, any particular inspiration for the name Bedditt?
Well, I thought you were talking about his name.
No, he's got an awesome name too, but I figure he doesn't know what inspired his parents, right? So.
Well, you got to take something to your bed, so why don't take our product with you?
There you go, Bedditt. All right, sounds good.
So what is Bedditt?
Well, Bedditt is a totally new way to track your sleep and wellness, because normally whenever you use any kind of wellness or well-being tracker, you need to connect some sensor and attach something to yourself, like a chest band or wristband or something, a headband.
Yeah.
So with Bedditt, it's a new innovation that you only have this like a very thin film sensor, and this goes into your bed under the sheet, and you don't have to wear any sensors.
Okay.
And every time you are in the bed, you sleep, you spend that one third of your life in the bed.
Yeah.
It automatically analyzes your sleep, your health, your heart rate, breathing, sleeping issues.
That can get my heart rate just by laying on it?
Yes.
Okay, so let's back up for a second, because sleep trackers, let's talk about sleep trackers in general first, because there's a lot of conversation about health trackers at the moment, a lot about sleep trackers, a lot of the health trackers also track sleep, but like you said, you have to wear something on your body. First of all, what is the point of tracking your sleep? Is it worth knowing? Can you actually do anything about it?
Yes. You can do a lot of things for your sleep. You can improve it in very many ways. And well, actually, if you think about the three key elements of the well-being, you have this exercising, you have nutrition, and you have recovery, you have sleep. So many things that exercising and nutrition are the most important, for example, in weight watching and weight losing. But it's not really so, because there are so many studies showing that even if you exercise enough, you have the calories calculated and nutritionist is okay, you don't really lose weight. And if you lose weight, you lose actually muscle tissue instead of fat tissue
if you're
not sleeping well.
Because your body needs time to rebuild and recuperate, right?
Yeah, the whole metabolism is working during the night, and all this hormonal activity is happening during the night, and they are regulating your appetite and everything. So it's extremely important to know how you sleep. And it's very common that people don't really understand their sleep. And especially people with sleeping issues and sleeping problems like sleeping apnea, it's normally their spouse who notices that they are snoring, but otherwise they don't know about it. 90% of people, for example, with sleeping apnea are undiagnosed and they are really suffering about it.
Because they're just tossing and turning all night and they never really get to get good sleep?
Yes, and it's actually extremely risky for your health, because during the apnea event, your oxygen saturation level drops and it increases your blood pressure, and it will eventually cause all kind of health risks like diabetes risk and stroke and heart attack. It will
not good.
Kill you.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So that answers my question. We definitely want to know how our sleep is being.
And if you think about athletes, they really need to know their stress and recovery status. We use heart rate variability to analyze the stress and recovery, and so the athlete can assess their training and really optimize their training and performance so that they don't get overstressed.
Okay, so that's why we want to track our sleep.
How?
How are we doing it with this?
So we put this on the bed, we put the sheets on it, then what? What is it? It looks like it's got a USB connection on it.
Yeah, it's just for the power, because we tried to make this so that you don't have to do anything with it after you have put it in your bed, because so you don't have to recharge or change any batteries.
Right.
It's all the time powered with a USB power supply, like some iPhone charger.
Yeah,
or anything.
Like any little, like how many amps does it require?
It requires just a normal 500 milliamps. Like you can use it from any USB port you have available.
Okay.
And then it's in your bed. It has a Bluetooth connection. and it's otherwise it's fully automatic, and it works as a mobile application. So you have your mobile device at the bedside desk, and you just go to sleep.
Now, does it have some storage in it, so it's gathering the data, and then when I Bluetooth to it, it dumps it to my phone?
Or it has some storage, but currently we are trying to get it so that it actually collects data, and it's constantly connected to your mobile device also during the night, because it can also give you information in the middle of the night. If you wake up and want to see something, it can already have analyzed, and you can give feedback, for example, why I woke up or why I went to the...
What kind of information could it give me why I woke up? Like,
no, you would tell it why.
Oh, you can input it as well.
I was like, that's a pretty smart device.
Yeah. Yeah. But could you also set it to somehow wake me up if there was a problem?
Yes, it has an integrated smart alarm clock. So it does not, because it's not a medical device, it's a wellness product.
Yep.
So it will not like alarm you because of any heart issues or breathing issues.
Right.
But it will wake you up based on your sleep rhythm. And also, if you want to wake up in a certain sleep state, it can do that. For example, there are these people doing lucid dreaming. So they can also use it for wake them up during the or giving their signal when they are in a REM sleep state.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I actually have talked to a couple of people who have been been using smart alarms to wake them up.
Yeah.
You know, that they're not in the REM sleep cycle, and they say it actually makes them feel a lot better and a lot more awake, or like they rested better.
Yeah.
So there seems to be something to it. It's very interesting. I haven't personally tracked my sleep a whole lot.
I don't sleep
little
well.
Little bits here and there. I toss and turn a lot.
I toss and turn a lot.
Yeah.
And I was in the Marine Corps a long time ago, and in the Marine Corps, they condition you to wake up very easily, which makes sense, you know, but I've never gotten over that. So I don't know that there's any hope for that, or if I could be trained
to. There's no hope for you, John.
I know that, but, you know. It is very interesting. So how are they available now?
We have currently the professional version available. It has been on the market over 18 months.
Oh.
It's been used by professionals in Europe, the sleep doctors, the personal trainers at gyms, and so on. And now this new consumer version, we are now pre-marketing it, and we are using a crowdfunding platform to pre-market it.
Which one?
We now just...
deciding?
We're just trying to, for example, probably will be Kickstarter now.
Yep.
Okay.
And at least we're trying to get to the Kickstarter now. And so it will start, we start shipping in October, and it will retail for $149. But now whoever pre-orders it from the crowdfunding platform, they will get it for $99.
Wow, that's a good deal.
Okay.
So what's the difference between the professional version and the consumer version?
Well, first of all, the claims, what we claim it to do, because we don't want to get this, this will not be FDA approved, at least for a very for some time.
Gotcha.
And so we keep the professional level as different claims. It will measure the similar things, and it will have almost the same accuracy. Both will have the same accuracy. And we're using the same validations, because it's exactly the same measurement, exactly the same algorithms, but we are not giving exactly, we don't diagnose, we don't do any treatment
with
this one.
Okay.
And another main difference is that the professional version, the sensor is wired to the gateway device, which is our special device, which is on your desk, bedside desk.
Okay.
And it is connected to your own internet connection using Wi-Fi or Ethernet, and everything is running as a web app. And the new one, you have the Bluetooth and a mobile app, and you don't need that expensive gateway device.
Okay. What if somebody wanted it? Can they buy the Pro version right now?
Yes, they can order it from our international web shop.
And
how much?
Yeah, how much is that?
It's about $500.
Okay.
Oh, that's less than I thought for
yeah, like for
a Pro.
All that.
Yeah. Can we see a look at the app itself?
Yeah, the app itself, it gives the... It gives you the summary, then it gives you the, well, it gives you the coaching, it gives you the events, what happened during the night, about your heart and snoring periods and everything.
We're going to try and get a little close up of it here.
You got to get it in the middle of the screen.
Focusing. Yeah, that's not gonna.
Yeah.
Well,
you will find a lot of information on our website about the screens and everything.
Bedit.com or what?
Bedit.com.
Okay, yeah. BEDDIT.com.
Yeah, and also about all the scientific validations, publications, algorithms. You can get information from Bedit.com/science.
Okay.
Awesome.
And Oil Man in the chat room would like to know how many OSs you're going to have it available for. Just iOS, or are you going to go Android as well?
Android as well.
Android as well.
Yeah. How about BlackBerry?
Well, iOS and Android, that's
initially. Like, BlackBerry.
Yeah.
Actually, BlackBerry, certain, the new like Q and Z10s, they can run Android Android apps. They can make them run in there. So.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cool. Well, thank you so much for your time and showing us and kind of educating us about our sleep patterns, because it seems more important than I thought previously.
So. And make sure, let us know whenever you get the Kickstarter started, so we can let everybody know and we can hop on.
I will let you know. I hope it will be still during this week. I hope.
Okay.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Cool.
So you guys keep an eye out on that. We will be coming back to you guys with a lot more gadgety, techy stuff here at the show, learning all sorts of.
You say coming back as if, what, are we taking a break or something?
No.
Oh, okay.
Not taking a break. Sorry.
Oh, I thought we were going to get a break or something.